SCA has moved in the state of California to get to make it a legal requirement to call yourself a trainer, to be a trainer, to fly a flag, to be certified by an agency that holds, and they named one particular accreditation. Turns out the only ones that have that accreditation. Yeah, how do you like that for cheating? And so we're going to get it. We're going to get accredited. And what a pain in the ass that is, because it's not going to make the training any better. It's not going to make the certs any better. I really think that we find a better fit and will endure less resistance if we portray this as sport rather than fitness. And truthfully is that CrossFit trainers have way more in common with rugby coaches and soccer coaches and swim coaches than they do what's going on in the commercial gyms. Though it may be that our stated aim is truer to the aim of what happens in the fitness environment, our methods and our results look much more like sport. And in fact, you know, look, every time you run a class, you're keeping score, right? And it is physical activity, right? Highly competitive, no? You know, and you got a first place, a second place, a third place, so it qualifies it readily as sport. And one of the things that happens in sport is that our risk tolerance is very, very different than it is for fitness. See, fitness is supposed to be, in the States, I presume here, it's supposed to be perfectly safe. Well, what is the most assured way of rendering fitness training perfectly safe? That's exactly right. Render it perfectly ineffective. So if I were to call, hey, we're all in a fitness program, I'm just gonna talk, you don't do anything, put your shit down, you know, just listen, and what you're gonna find is, wow, I've got the world's safest fitness program. Do nothing. That's largely what's happening. Now, I believe that it would measure up that in the short-term sense, a CrossFit session has a higher propensity to cause injury than one of these fucking sessions. But if we were to look at this impact over time, that what we'd see is that the doing this and this is fundamentally carries greater risk in the longer sense, because I'm not preparing you for life. Okay? But that view isn't being taken yet. Why? Because this measure isn't being looked at. We need to increase our risk tolerance to produce a better result to get people fitter. This is very much like John Boyd's telling the Air Force that if you want fewer guys killed in combat, you need more killed in training. We've got Dan McDougall, the CrossFit consigliere, one of our attorneys, is a rugby coach at Georgia Tech. And he says, I get it perfectly, coach, in his beautiful southern accent I won't imitate here, not without beer. He says that he's fun to impersonate. He says that every year we have to take the new kids and teach them how to tackle. Have to. Because I can't put them in a rugby game without teaching them a match without teaching them how to tackle. And every year in learning how to tackle, one, maybe two get hurt. Should the solution be then to not teach them how and just send them into games? See, one of the ways to ignore, to hide from the downside of your approach is to not measure it in the long term. And so I can create perfectly safe fitness and the carnage will occur outside of my gym. It'll happen on the streets, it'll happen in combat, it'll happen if the house catches on fire, it'll happen if there's a flood, a fire, are you with me? It'll happen in a precipitous drop of this curtain. There's another issue here too. I mean, look, if you just look at one of these axes like longevity, who here wants to live to be 400 years old if for 325 years you have to watch fucking Oprah and you're getting fed green jello on a spoon and someone's wiping your ass for you and you live in a bed? You know, I for one am not looking for that. I hope to avoid that. And if it, so you know, the goal isn't longevity. The goal isn't multitude of durations of effort. And it's really not power output. It's about all of this. I want to be powerful across broad time and modal domains for as long as I possibly can. That's what I want. It really is. It really is. I think. And I think it speaks to quality of life. So I got a guy at 90 years old, you've heard my example, and he's out chasing ladies and he's at the ATM getting money, and if you grab him, he's gonna knock you to the ground and put his foot in your throat, and he's lives, you know, independently. And then I've got it. What do I care about disease state? Suppose that guy has cancer and heart disease, but he can do all that shit, versus someone who is being taken to the ATM in a wheelchair but is free of cancer and heart disease. The relationship to disease state and this curtain is very much like the relationship of VO2 max and lactate threshold and performance. It's a weak predictor of it's a weak correlate, a weak correlate. The answer is, here's the analogy. Would you trade, and we're just looking, taking this comparison, if you will, from 2D to 3D, who here would take an increase in a VO2 max for a decrease in work capacity? An increase in lactate threshold for a decrease in work capacity. In other words, your VO2 max went up, but you lost the match. You lost the race. You lost the game. You don't want it, right? Keep VO2 max. Here's where VO2 max matters to me. If I'm ever in maximum sustainable oxygen consumption race, so if we're going to have gas exchange Olympics and I'm in the oxygen category, I want a big VO2 max. But other than that, what I want to do is I want to win the rugby match. I want to get out of the fucking fire unburned. I want to get my own ass to the ATM machine. And now let's go look at this thing over age. What is it you want to be at 90? Do you want to be fully physically capable, or do you want to be disease free? And if you make me take a trade-off there, I'm going to tell you that I'm going to take every time I want full functionality. The disease-free part only matters to me to the extent that it impacts my functionality. Who here would worry about a disease that would never impact your functionality?